San Francisco has given away millions to lure tech companies to the city. Now one city leader says it's time they start paying back. Only on 5, Joe Vasquez on the new tax plan that could generate $100 million a year.
As San Francisco booms, it's no secret the transportation infrastructure is going bust. How will the city pay for needed improvements to roads and traffic and pedestrian safety? Supervisor Aaron Peskin is suggesting a new corporate tax called a gross receipts tax on large property landlords who lease office space. The money would go directly for transportation improvements.
Our current tax structure charges 0.3% at its highest tier.
Peskin's new tax proposal, a 2.5% tax on rent for commercial property. Small business owners and nonprofits would be exempt. Downtown commercial property includes law offices, accounting firms, and other businesses. It also is the home to many of the biggest names in tech.
This should all be seen in light of the fact that the city actually gave tax breaks to attract many of these companies who have become extremely profitable. And I think now it's time to give back.
Last year, several supervisors, including Peskin, proposed a tech tax that would have directly taxed tech companies in San Francisco. That effort failed. Supervisor Peskin insists this new proposal is not a tech tax. Still, it will compel some of these big tech companies to indirectly pay more tax money to the city. Depending on their lease agreements, the landlords could pass along the tax costs to their big-name customers.
When you have a gross receipts tax, you can end up creating political winners and losers, and that's bad tax policy.
Jim Lazarus of the San Francisco Chamber of Commerce says enough with the tax increases.
San Francisco is collecting over $5 billion of general tax revenues as part of a $10 billion budget. There are enough taxes being collected in San Francisco.
Joe Vasquez, KPIX5.